Evening, Limitless Fam. We are really excited to be back with you online. Thank you so much for connecting with us and joining us tonight. So, we are really, really excited for the new year. We are really hopeful that God is going to do something great this year. And obviously, to start off this year, we are kicking off with a new series. As you saw in our social media accounts, the new series is called I Am. And this series is based off the seven statements in the book of John, which is a book in the Bible that Jesus says. And this week we are going to be kicking off with I Am the Bread of Life. Lauren will be delivering that to us later on this evening. But before we get into the fun and games on this farm, I have a few notices, or what we like to call the schedule. So this is what is scheduled for this week. Obviously, Mondays, we have Youth Online. Please connect with us on YouTube. All our videos will be out on YouTube. On Tuesdays, we have some fun and fantastic Challenge Tuesdays from Lauren. So please do connect with those, and please do send in your videos and attempts of doing these challenges. Lauren is spending a lot of time preparing them and thinking about them. On Thursday, we have our Thought Thursday videos. So a leader every week will bring a thought of the week for you to mull over and think about. And then on Friday, by popular demand, we are bringing back Limitless Gaming. So on Friday night over Zoom, we will be playing Among Us from 6:30 till 7:30. So please do connect with us. Please do invite your friends. It will be great to connect with you. And now, without further ado, we are going to play some games.
Hey, tonight's game is the most high-tech game you have ever seen in your life. Tonight, we are going to be aiming for points in the bucket at the bottom here. This is something you can even do at home, set it up with your recycling, just put it out the bin. I wouldn't put it on an antique table, your parents might not be too happy. But grab those in your household with you and see who can get the highest score. I'm going to have four rolls for this and I'm going to see what I can get, and then the others are going to come and jump on and have a go also. So, let's see if this goes anywhere. What have I got? Is that a 10? Oh, 10 to start. Right, test them in maths as well really. This is all counting as part of homeschooling, I'm guessing as well. No, not a 10 again. All right, 20, we're on 20. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm gonna aim for something higher. Let's see if this happens. What's that one?
20.
So I'm on 40 points, and that's my three rolls, so I've got another roll to go. 50 points. I'm liking that. Let's see how you can do. If you set this up at home, film it, show us what you can do, and I'm going to now hand over and let someone else have a go.
Okay, so it's my turn. Obviously, we've just seen Hannah score 50, so I'm going to see if I can do any better. I'm going to aim for the Pringles Hub because I'm ambitious, which is probably about 40 points. Yes! Okay, you ready? Roll one. I got 10. Damn it. Okay, not bad. I got 50 to beat. I got three more rolls. Oh, I bounced out. That's a shame. That is shocking. I can't catch. Okay, two more rolls. I think I'm just too ambitious. 10. Ah, 20. I got one more roll. I'm gonna be ambitious to go for this cup for 40 points. Put it in the chat if you think I can do it, because I don't think I can. No, can't. Don't play the wrong. Yes! What's that?
We'll see on that one.
Woo! 60 points!
60 points! You beat
yes,
me!
Boy.
You beat me!
Okay, yeah, that's it, and we will be moving on. Fam, so we are bringing something new to you guys this year. It's what we're calling Memory Verses. And this basically is, it links to the series that we are doing. So obviously this one will link to the I am statements. And what we want you to do is remember it. To remember it off by heart, and then on Monday next week, we want you to put it in the chat. But there's got to be some trust in this, guys, because we won't know if you're sat reading it and typing it out. So we've got faith in you, and we trust you guys not to be doing that. So please do participate in this. We are really excited about this. So let's kick this off. It says this: I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall not thirst. John 6, verse 35. Okay, do we get that? I'll say it again. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst. John 6, verse 35. This week, guys, remember this and bring it for next week.
If this is the answer, what is the question? Oh, it's backwards. It says 12 million. If it is backwards. If that's the answer, what might the question be? Well, I'll tell you. So, the question is, how many loaves of bread are sold each day? And I know it seems like such a huge number, but there's 12 million loaves of bread are sold every single day. Now you might be thinking, what? Why this question? Well, let me tell you, friends. So this week we're going to be looking at, and over the next 7 weeks, we're going to be looking at the I Am series. And this week we're going to be looking at, if you haven't already guessed, the bread of life. And now we find this in John chapter 6, verses 22-35, which says, our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness. As it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Jesus then said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. They said to him, sir, give us the bread always. And Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst. Now, Jesus isn't actually made out of bread. Let's put that out there. But it is an analogy that is used quite a lot throughout the four Gospels. Like we find it in Matthew 26, verse 26, which is the story of the Last Supper, where he says, this is my body broken for you. And he takes the bread and physically, oh my goodness, breaks it. There we go, boom. So Jesus is saying that as long as we stick with him, as long as we keep our eyes on the cross, we will never be hungry. He uses the idea of bread as a way of helping the disciples and the people of Israel, and even people today, to understand the message that he is trying to get across. Something so simple as bread has such a powerful meaning. Can I encourage you to do something, either starting this week or just whenever you're ready? Can I encourage you to find some time during the week with your family, even if it's a Sunday during church or after church, to sit down and experience communion together. Now, if you don't know what communion is, it's basically what I've mentioned earlier.
It's where we take the body of Christ, which is the bread, and we take the blood of Christ, which is usually grape juice or something, and we just remember everything he has done for us. Can I encourage you to, I don't know, experience communion together with your family, and give thanks for everything that Jesus is doing and has done in your life. So, are you hungry for Jesus?